Hey, this is Denver Riddle with Color Grading Central. This is a 15-minute color grading crash course for Adobe Premiere. You'll learn how to grade in this tutorial, you'll learn the Lumetri color tools, and together we'll create this really amazing look on footage you can download and follow along with. Also, I want to let you know about a free live training event I'll be doing. We'll go into even more depth. You can ask me questions. It's free to attend. Details are below this video in the description. All right, let's do this thing. Here inside of Premiere, if you download the clips provided in the description, you'll find a few pre-trimmed clips from cinematographer and good buddy Chris McKechnie. I've also included an XML and some instructions for you on how to bring this footage into Premiere as an edited sequence. I thought that you'd think that was pretty awesome. Now, the focus of this tutorial is on color grading, so we're going to work mainly in the color workspace, and that will bring up the Lumetri color tools. In the top section, we have the scopes. We have the program panel, where we see the clip we're currently working on, and the Lumetri color panel, where we can perform our color grading. It's also worth pointing out the effects control panel, where we can do some other things, including adding and tracking color masks, but more on that in just a bit. Now, before we jump in and start grading this thing, let's discuss basic terminology for how we define color. The three basic terms that we use to define color are hue, saturation, and luma. Hue is the name we call colors, saturation is the intensity or vividness of a hue, and luma is the brightness or shade of hue. It's also important to know how to read the scopes, which can be super beneficial. If you're in the color workspace, the scopes should appear, but if not, just click on the Lumetri Scopes tab. The three scopes I always use are the waveform, the RGB parade, and the vector scope. The waveform lets us correct for exposure. If I overlay an image on top of the waveform, you can see that the trace, the stuff you see here, actually corresponds with the image of the two people as they move toward each other. The RGB parade scope is helpful for correcting white balance issues, and it reads similar to the waveform, other than it's broken out into the individual color channels of red, green, and blue. With this scope, it makes it easier to spot imbalances if either the image is too cool or too warm. The vector scope corresponds directly with the color wheel, and I've overlaid it here for convenience. It shows us what colors are in the image as well as their saturation. The further the trace extends from the center of the scope, the more saturated or vivid the colors are. Here's a simple but powerful workflow for doing color correction. We first correct the exposure or the brightness of the image. Second, the white balance or color temperature if there are any issues. And lastly, the saturation by either increasing or reducing it. This will make more sense as we actually do it. Let's first make a correction to the exposure of the image using the basic correction panel. Now, if you look at the controls in the basic corrections panel, you'll see controls for highlights and shadows, but also for whites and blacks. Lumetri uses a different terminology that's slightly different than other grading applications, but here's how the controls work. The blacks control adjusts the darkest parts or the very bottom darkest point, and the whites control adjusts the brightest or the very top of the image. The shadows control affects the tonal range between the shadows and the midtones if, say, you want to recover or darken details there, and the highlights control affects the tonal range between the highlights and the midtones or the upper part of the image if, say, again, you want to recover or brighten those details in the higher areas. We'll adjust the shadows first with the blacks control while watching the waveform. We want to bring the trace and the shadows down until the darkest parts of the image sits right above zero. Then we'll bring up the highlights with the whites control so the brightest parts of the trace sits right about here near the top. Then let's darken the undertones or the area between the shadows and the midtones by pulling the shadow slider to the left. This will help us remove that washed out look on the talent's face. And then I'll adjust this a little more until we have good contrast and exposure. Next, we'll fix the color temperature since the image is looking cool. Our goal is to neutralize or white balance the whites, and we'll want to find something in the image that is white. In this case, we're going to use this part of the image as a reference and its corresponding trace in the RGB parade scope where we can see the blue trace elevated above the red and green. Our goal is to get these color channels to align evenly, and when they do, we'll get white. Now, we can do this manually with the temperature and tint sliders, or we can save some time by using Premiere's Auto White Balance Selector. To do that, we just need to select and click on the white part of the image, And voila, the temperature and tint sliders automatically move to white balance the shot and the traces are aligned in the RGB parade scope. Now, if for whatever reason we're not happy with the result, we can still manually adjust those sliders to our liking. Lastly, let's boost the color a little bit by increasing the saturation. And here's what the clip looks like before and after the correction. Pretty amazing, right? On the next shot, we'll repeat the same procedure, going for a nice balance of exposure with the blacks, whites, shadows, and highlights controls. The color temperature in the shot looks good, so we can just add some saturation. Moving to the next shot, we'll want to match it to the first shot for obvious reasons, since they are different angles from the same scene. To give us a good starting point, let's copy the correction from the first clip to the second one. We'll go to the first shot, select it, and use the keyboard shortcut Command-C or Control-C if you're on Windows. We'll then go back to this clip, right-click on it, and choose Paste Attributes from the drop-down menu. Make sure the Lumetri color effect is checked, and then click OK. This copies the correction and gives us a good starting point, but you'll see that we still have some matching issues. The image is way too cool, and it can use some additional contrast too. And definitely our talent's face is too dark. To help with matching, we can go to the color wheels and match panel and activate the comparison view. Now we can see a side-by-side comparison of our clip and any other clip in the timeline. There are also vertical and horizontal split options, but we'll stick to the side-by-side option. Now here's the really cool thing. In the side-by-side view, we can compare them visually and in the scopes as well, so this makes matching a breeze. To match the traces better, we'll drop the shadows with the blacks control, increase the highlights, and then decrease the shadows to compensate. We can see in the waveform that both traces look like they're at the same level. To improve the color match, I'll drag the temperature to the right to warm it up, and the tint slightly to the left. We'll then just decrease the saturation. All right, that's a nice looking match. Okay, now let's disable the comparison view option. The face is looking a little dark, so to brighten the talent's face for the shot, we can do that with a mask where we're effectively relighting the scene, something really cool we can do. Now, in order to do this using Lumetri, we'll need to add a second instance. To do that, we need to open the effect panel, and then if we go to the project panel, we'll see a double arrow located at the upper right side. Go ahead and click on that and choose effects from the drop-down menu. Once we find the Lumetri color effect, we'll drag it to the effect controls panel, and this adds a second instance of Lumetri where we can now use a mask. I'll go ahead and add a mask and resize and position it like so over the face, and then rotate it a little to match the angle of his face. Now to brighten his face, we'll increase the shadows and highlights. Playing it back, you can see that the talent's face moves. So we'll want to address that. Going to the effects control panel, we can easily and effortlessly track this mask by clicking on the track forward button. And bada bing, bada bang. The shape moves perfectly with the movement of our talent. Really amazing stuff that we can do here inside of Adobe Premiere. In the interest of time, I've already gone ahead and finished performing the base corrections to these remaining clips, but let's say in this next shot, for whatever reason, the director decided he didn't like the woman's purple hair and would prefer it to be black with red highlights. Well, the cool thing is we can do that with the qualifier tool in Lumetri. So we'll need to add another Lumetri color effect, open up the HSL secondary panel, and then with the eyedropper, let's click and drag through the talent's hair to qualify it. To see what we've selected, let's turn on the highlight feature by clicking here. Now clearly, our selection isn't enough. We need to get those extra bits of hair. So to refine the key, let's increase the hue, saturation, and luma width. Then to remove the other unwanted elements that we're picking up here, we'll use a mask. Okay, now let's turn the highlight feature off. and drag the color wheel's control until the hair is a bright orange color. We'll then reduce the saturation significantly and drop the brightness. Here's what it looks like when we play it back. Worked like a charm. Fixed it in post. Okay, now we're to the really fun part, and that's creating an awesome look for these clips. I'm going to show you a quick way to apply the same look on top of all these clips, and this will save us time and ensure that we have a consistent look across the board. To do that, we'll go to the project panel, right-click, and select from the drop-down menu. We'll choose New Item, then Adjustment Layer. A prompt will appear, and we'll just click OK. We'll drag the adjustment layer to the second video layer over top of our video clips, and now any adjustments or color treatments we apply here will be applied to all the clips underneath the adjustment layer. Pretty sweet, huh? All right, now let's create the look. Make sure that the adjustment layer is selected, and we're going to skip and go straight past the basic correction panel to the curves where we'll have more creative control. And a quick crash course on the way this works, in case you haven't already used these in, say, a program like Photoshop, is the bottom point adjusts the shadows, the top point adjusts the highlights, and we can add as many points as we want on the curve in between to shape the tonal range. To give the contrast a soft, muted look, we'll reduce the contrast by dragging the top point down and the bottom point up. I'll then make a point here and drag up to brighten the midtones, and then another point here, and here, and then drag down to adjust the density in the shadows. Now for color, to give us a warm, sunny California look, we'll go to the blue channel and drag the top point down, subtracting blue to warm it up. Then with the bottom point, we'll drag to the right, subtracting even more blue from the shadows. Going to the red channel, we'll drag the bottom point up, adding more red or warmth to the shadows. And then another point here and drag down to balance the midtones so the skin isn't too red. And lastly, another point here and drag down to create color contrast by pushing teal colors into the shadows. Finally, we'll add some saturation by going to the hue saturation curves, clicking anywhere on the circle, and dragging it out to increase the overall saturation to make it pop more. To take this look even further, let's make some secondary or isolated adjustments to make elements in the scene fit better with our look. Namely, we want green to appear more yellow and blues to appear more aqua or cyan. We'll need to add another instance of Lumetri, and under the HSL secondary tab, we can make green grass appear more yellow by clicking on the set color picker and selecting the grass. I'll activate the highlights feature so we can see our selection, and I'll refine the color mask like so with the HSL sliders. Once we're happy with the selection, we can refine it a little bit more with the denoise and blur sliders, then deactivate the highlights feature. Now we can change the green to appear more yellow with the temperature and tint sliders. Finally, I'll reduce the saturation a little bit. Now, to make the blues appear more aqua, we'll need to add another instance of Lumetri Color and then isolate the blues with the HSL secondary tool like we did with the greens. Give me just a moment while I do that. Now with the color wheels, we'll push a little bit of that aqua color into each. And darken the blues a little bit by dragging the midtone slider down. And finally, let's increase the saturation of the aqua colors. All right, finally, we want to reduce the contrast in the highlights to add even more of that soft, muted look. So we'll add one more instance of Lumetri, go to the curves panel, and with the Luma curve selected, we'll drag the top point down. Then make a point here and drag up to brighten the midtones. What an awesome look! If you really like this look and want to save some steps by applying this as a lookup table, you can download that LUT when you sign up for the live workshop event. Now, I know that we covered a lot and I skipped over a lot of details, but what I wanted to do for you is give you the big picture. And if you like this tutorial and you want to see even more, then sign up for my free workshop event. We'll go into more depth, we'll cover more color theory, you can ask questions, and we'll give you slides and raw footage from the workshop that you can download and practice along with. So to save your spot, just follow the links in the description below this video, and I promise you, it will be well worth your time, and you'll get a lot better from one simple training. So I hope you enjoyed this crash course as much as I enjoyed creating it for you, and I look forward to seeing you at the training. Have a great day.